Hello and welcome to Magdalene Chapel. We're so happy that you're joining us for this liturgy on the seventh Sunday of Easter. Our Mass intentions for today are for Colleen McMahon Doyle and Cecilia Clemente. Our celebrant for today is Father Peter Horton. Thank you for all the prayers for our graduates last weekend. We had two wonderful graduation ceremonies, and we look forward to seeing how our graduates carry the mission of La Roche into the next chapter of their lives. Thanks also to so many of you who have donated to the Sister Candace Intricasso Student Emergency Fund. Your contributions are really making a difference in the lives of our students. Please consider making a donation to this fund. You can do it online on the same page that you find this Mass. Any amount is helpful. And we also ask that you just continue to keep La Roche in your prayers. God bless you for your generosity.
Morning as a people of faith to continue our celebration of the Easter season and the gift of new life that we have and receive in this Eucharist. As we come to the table of our Lord, we do so with great joy in the hopes that he will fill us once again with his grace, his life, and his peace, and renew our hearts, that as we are renewed in his name, we may go forth to renew our world in the light and the love of Jesus Christ. With joy we gather together today as always, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, the love of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the friendship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, as we come together to celebrate these sacred mysteries, all of us are aware of times we have not lived and loved as Christ invites. Let us open our hearts and ask our Lord to enter in with the gifts of his mercy and compassion. You are the resurrection and the life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are our reconciliation and our peace. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You grant us your forgiveness. You fill us with new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in our hearts and our lives.
Let us pray. Graciously hear our prayers, O Lord, so that we who believe that the Savior of the human race is with you in your glory may experience as he promised until the end of the world his abiding presence among us. He who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our first reading is from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter stood up in the midst of the brothers. There was a group of about 120 persons in the one place. And he said, "My brothers, the scripture had to be fulfilled, which the Holy Spirit spoke beforehand through the mouth of David concerning Judas, who was the guide for those who arrested Jesus. He was numbered among us and was allotted a share in this ministry. For it is written in the book of Psalms, 'May another take his office.' Therefore, it is necessary that one of the men who accompanied us the whole time the Lord Jesus came and went among us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day on which he was taken up from us, become with us a witness to his resurrection." So they proposed two: Judas, called Barsabbas, who was also known as Justus, and Matthias. Then they prayed, "You, Lord, who know the hearts of all, show which one of these two you have chosen to take the place in this apostolic ministry from which Judas turned away to go to his own place." Then they gave lots to them, and the lot fell upon Matthias, and he was counted with the 11 apostles. The word of the Lord. Our second reading is from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God. Yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him and he in us, that he has given us his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testify that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God, and God in him. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Lifting up his eyes to heaven, Jesus prayed, saying, Holy Father, keep them in your name that you had given me, so that they may be one just as we are one. When I was with them, I protected them in your name that you gave me, and I guarded them. And none of them was lost, except the Son of Destruction, in order that the Scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you. I speak this in the world so that they may share my joy completely. I gave them your word, and the world hated them, because they do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. I do not ask that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, so I sent them into the world. And I consecrate myself for them, so that they also may be consecrated in truth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You may have heard this story before, but it involves a first-generation Italian immigrant named Maria. And Maria had a job cleaning her local parish church, which she did faithfully every day. But at the beginning of her day, she went to Mass and Communion, and then she spent some time in prayer. And the last part of her prayer was she made a novena to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. So she would position herself near the Marian altar in her church and quietly pray the novena. Well, another co-worker saw her there, and so he went and hid in the back of the church, laying down in one of the pews so she couldn't see him. And she was quietly praying her novena, and he goes, Maria. And she doesn't move, doesn't even turn around. And she's fervently praying this novena. And so he tries again. He goes, Maria. Nothing. No response, nothing. He's getting really frustrated. So finally he goes, Maria. "This is Jesus." And Maria says, "Please be quiet, I'm speaking to your mother." We have a tradition in our church, a great tradition of prayer. We have prayer in many forms. And intercessory prayer is one of the greatest. We have our prayer of intercession that people send in to us, and we keep them in front of the altar to remind us that these petitions are special and that the people mentioned in them are part of our community and that they are worthy of our prayers and our time and our devotion. However, every prayer in the Catholic tradition is addressed to the Father through Jesus in the Spirit. So you'll notice all the prayers of the liturgy are addressed to the Father through Jesus in the Spirit. So why do we pray to the saints? We really don't pray to the saints. What we're doing when we pray a novena or a special prayer is we're asking that saint, in Maria's case, her patron, to pray with us for whatever intention. And so we're asking them to join us in our prayer. And because of their closeness to the Lord, we feel they may have a greater voice. And it's a wonderful tradition. But all of our prayers are channeled to the Father through the Son in the Spirit. Today, though, we hear something we don't usually hear in the gospel. We usually hear Jesus telling us, pray, pray often. We hear Jesus going off to pray. But today, we hear Jesus' prayer, and the prayer is for us. What an amazing concept. Jesus is praying for us every day. I don't think we often think of it that way. He asks that we be consecrated in the name of the Father. He asks that we be consecrated in the truth that is Him, the life, and that we be guided to that life by the Spirit. And then He sends us forth. So when He sends us forth, that means we have a new responsibility, a new opportunity, a new challenge. We have to ask ourselves, do we answer His prayer? We always ask the Lord to answer our prayers, but do we consider ourselves the answer to Jesus' prayer? And according to John in his gospel and in his letters, it's quite simple. To answer the prayer of Jesus, you must love. Love your God, love yourself, and love your neighbor. It's not rocket science. It's a great challenge, but the simple thing is, God is love, therefore we must be that love. So we need to find ways to answer the prayer of Jesus in our time. And as a church, we've done that for centuries. We've answered His prayers by loving people to life, through working for justice, for working for better social conditions. We work together to build a stronger community of faith, hope, and love. We reach out to one another in times of sorrow. We comfort one another in those times. We encourage one another in times of disillusionment. And we hold one another's hand when we need to. These are all ways that we answer the prayer of Christ. And as we see some hope at the end of this pandemic, which is not over yet, we can show the greatest act of love ever. Get the vaccine. Protect your sisters and brothers. Protect yourself. Continue to wear a mask. You know, we keep saying these things are violations of our freedom. Our freedom is a gift, but it comes with great responsibility. It's not a freedom to do whatever we want. Many people think that freedom in the United States means we can do whatever we want, whenever we want. So we can say whatever we want, carry whatever we want, do what we want, don't do what we don't want to do. The Constitution couches that freedom as a freedom for the common good. United States,
not individual states. United nation. And so that's why it's important for us to make sure our love is a community affair. We are responsible for one another. We're all sisters and brothers with one Father in whose name we have been consecrated. One Father who makes us a family. One Father who sends his Spirit. So not only do we pray for what we need, we pray and act as the answer to the prayer of Jesus. You know, this past Thursday, we celebrated the Ascension. And I like the one gospel account where it says, they stood there looking up. And finally, the angel said to them, boys, go. It's time for you to take over. You have a job. You've been consecrated in the name. You've been consecrated in the truth. As he was sent by the Father, now Jesus sends you. Go. One of the greatest theological movies of all time, Bruce Almighty, had one of the greatest statements of all time. When God and Bruce are having a conversation, after Bruce realized that all the power that God gave him, even though it was limited to 6 blocks in Buffalo, not only gave him the ability to do whatever he wanted, but it came with great responsibility. He had to hear everyone's prayer. He had to answer in a way that was best for them. I always love it when he has that final conversation with God, and God, as played by Morgan Freeman, looks at Bruce, as played by Jim Carrey, and says, you people spend too much time looking up. Look at each other. Be the miracle. My sisters and brothers, may we always be the answer to the prayer of Christ.
And now, as it is our tradition, following the tradition of our early church, let us profess our faith according to the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. And now, my sisters and brothers, with hearts filled with grace and hope, let us turn to our loving and provident God and ask him to hear and answer the prayers we now offer for ourselves, our world, our church.
Please respond, provident God, hear our prayer. We pray for the church and Pope Francis, that God will safeguard all the church as we offer witness to Jesus and loving service to those who are struggling. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Father God, hear our prayer.
We pray for the grace of Christian unity, that God will remove the misunderstandings, heal the wounds, and give us new vision so that the body of Christ can provide a common witness to love in the world. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for a healing in our nation, that God will heal the wounded relationships and mistrust among people, and help us to work together for the common good. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father God, hear our prayer.
For all burdened by poverty, that God will open new pathways for them to find education, employment, and housing. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for all in the La Roche University community and for all of our prayer requests, that the Spirit will help us discern God's call, see through the diverse situations in our lives, and faithfully follow Christ on the path of life and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father God, hear our prayer.
We remember all those who are sick, especially those suffering from COVID-19 and those suffering from cancer, mental health issues, and chronic illness. We pray that they would know healing and hope. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Father God, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially those among our family and friends, and those who have died by gun violence or bombings or by any other violent means, we pray that comfort will be given to their family members and friends who mourn them, and we also pray that God will welcome the deceased into the eternal banquet to live in joy forever in God's presence. Today, we especially remember Colleen McMahon Doyle and Cecilia Clemente, for whom this Mass is offered. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving and provident God, once again we turn to you in our time of need. As we thank you for all the blessings you have given us, we pray that you will make us an answer to the prayer of your Son, and that you in turn will answer our prayers, so that all that we need and all that we are may be accomplished in you, for the glory of your name and the goodness of all. We ask this as always, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that these gifts we have prepared will be a pleasing, acceptable offering to God, our loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and for the good of all God's holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful people with our sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotion we may one day come to the glory of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our privilege and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and humanity, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from us, but that we, the members of his body, might be confident of following where he is, when he, our head and founder, has gone before. And so, filled with Easter joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory. as they acclaim. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walks with us on our journey through life. Blessed too is your Son present in our midst whenever we are gathered together by his love. And when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify our gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer and die, on the night of that last supper, he took bread and said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup filled with wine. Again he gave you thanks, giving the cup to the disciples, said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of a new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sin may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Therefore, provident and loving Father, as we celebrate this memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. We offer you the bread of life and the cup of blessing. Look with favor on the offering of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have, we share, we become communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to the perfection of faith, hope, and love, together with Francis, our Pope, our Bishop David, and all the bishops, with the consecrated and religious, clergy, laity, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes and our hearts to the needs of our sisters and brothers. Inspire us in word and action to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Help us to serve them truly, following the example of Christ and his great command of love. May your church always stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, so that all people may be lifted up to a new hope in you. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Welcome them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life, love, and joy. Grant also to us, your faithful people, when our pilgrimage is done, that we may come to our eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, her devoted husband Joseph, the apostles and martyrs, Mary Magdalene Marie de la Roche, Wilhelm Kettler, and all your saints, we shall praise and exalt you with Christ, our risen Lord and Savior.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Let us now pray together in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your people, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a gesture of Christ's peace. This is Jesus, the resurrection and the life. This is the Lamb of God, who has conquered sin, fear, and death forever. Happy and blessed are we who share the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
As we prepare once again to be sent forth by the Lord Jesus, let us take this time to pray for peace. Peace in our hearts, our homes, our community, our nation, and our world. Lord, be with us, so that we might not look forward in fear to the changes in life. We are your very own, and we believe that you will lead us safely through all things. And when we cannot stand it, you will carry us in your arms. May we not fear what will happen tomorrow. You are our everlasting parent who cares for us today, and we believe that you will care for us every day. Lord, either shield us from suffering or give us the unfailing strength to bear it. May we be at peace and put to the good aside all anxious thoughts and imaginations. In this peace, we know that the love of God surrounds us. The light of God shines in us. The Spirit of God hovers over us. The presence of God unfolds in us. And wherever we are, God is. Through Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, family like us, we ask all of this now and forever. Amen. Let us pray. Hear us, O God, our Savior, and grant us confidence that through these sacred mysteries there will be accomplished in the whole body of the Church what has already come to pass in Christ, her head, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May our provident God bless and keep us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration here draws to a close. Our mission and journey continue. We go forth in peace to love and serve our God and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Have a good day.
Thank you.